Hey, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the look of a vintage screenshot from a hidden camera video recording. Open a photo you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. Before we begin, if you want to know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials, smash that subscribe button and please remember to click like if you like this video. Thank you. To ensure that your results will look similar to mine, check your photo's resolution. Go to Image and Image Size. If the resolution isn't 150 pixels per inch, just type it in. The width and height will increase or decrease depending on your photo's original resolution. Type in the original width and height, but before you do, make sure the chain link icon is locked so it retains its original shape or aspect ratio. The first step is to convert our photo into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 1.5 pixels. Go back to Filter and Lens Correction. Open the Custom tab and add a distortion of minus 20 to create a convex distortion that mimics the bird's eye distortion of many vintage hidden camera lenses. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Black and White. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. We'll fill it with 50% gray. To do this, press Shift plus the F5 at the top of the keyboard, or go to Edit and Fill. Click 50% gray. Convert it to a smart object. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Sketch folder and click Halftone Pattern. The pattern type is line, the size is 2, and the contrast is 50. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur 3 pixels. Change its blend mode to Vivid Light. Make a new layer. In Version CC and later, go to View, Guides, and New Guide Layout. On earlier versions, click New Guide and type in 50% for the vertical and horizontal orientations. In the numbers for columns and rows, type in 2 and make sure the width, height, and gutters are clear. Open the Elliptical Marquee tool and go to the center of the guides. Press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag out a circular selection from the center to the left and right edges of your image. Go to Select, Modify, and Feather. Feather at 50 pixels. Invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command-Shift-I. Fill the selection with black, which is our foreground color, by pressing Alt or Option plus Delete. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command-D. Next, we'll add our text, but before we do, we'll add guidelines for the text. Go to View, Guides, and New Guide Layout. Check Margin and type in 60 pixels in all the margins. Open the Horizontal Type tool and invert your foreground and background colors by clicking this icon or by pressing X on your keyboard. White is your foreground color. I provided the font Alterabro Pixel font that you could download. Its link is in my video's description or project files. Make its size 62 points and the aliasing none. Make its alignment centered. Click on your document. To increase or decrease the space between characters known as tracking, press and hold Alt or Option and the right or left arrow key on your keyboard. Go to the right of your text and drag it over so you can see it in its entirety. Type out the day, month, and year. Open your Move tool and drag your text to the inside corner of the guidelines. If it doesn't snap to it, go to View and click Snap. Make a copy of the text by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Drag the copy to the inside corner. Double-click the large T of the copy to highlight the text and type out the time of day. Open your Move tool and drag the text so it snaps to the inside corner. Make a copy of it and drag it down. Double-click the large T of this copy to highlight the text. I'll type in time code, but you can type in anything you like. Open your Move tool and drag it over until it snaps to the inside corner. Repeat the same steps for the lower left text. Shift-click the bottom text to make all the text layers active and convert them into one smart object. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 1 pixel. Double-click an empty area of the top layer to open its layer style window. Click Stroke. The size is 4 pixels and the position is outside. Hide the guidelines by pressing Ctrl or Command H. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.